Hello, my name is Jeffrey Blatt. I'm a technology and cybersecurity lawyer now based in Asia, but I professionally grew up in the Silicon Valley representing many leading tech companies. Today in this quick look, we're going to explore some of the issues regarding the current debate around encryption, the FBI versus Apple case, and the global implications on our business models. But first, a quick disclaimer. This is a dynamic and rapidly changing area of the law, and as a result, there can be no guarantee that what we discuss today will reflect the situation tomorrow. This quick look needs to be viewed as a snapshot in time. The other quick disclaimer I must make is that nothing in this quick look should be considered as providing legal advice. Every situation is different, and please seek competent legal advice for your specific situation from your own counsel. With that, let's take a quick look at this very interesting and critically important topic. The disclosures by Edward Snowden of mass surveillance and government access, both overt and covert, have set off a firestorm of controversy, both for and against government access to data stored in cloud-based systems or transmitted over the Internet. In addition, the compromises, hacks, and breaches of personal and corporate data that have taken place in the last few years, including breaches of U.S. government, health service, insurance, and consumer databases, have resulted in data security and integrity becoming board-level critical business risk areas that must be monitored and addressed. A major compromise of a cloud-based service, whether software as a service, infrastructure as a service, or a database, may raise serious business continuity risks and serious business reputation risks. In addition to the damage caused by the breach directly, the company, its directors and officers may face liability from customers by way of lawsuits and or regulatory fines and actions. A fundamental question to ask is who controls the decoding keys, the service provider or the data owner customer? If the service provider or the device manufacturer, like Apple, holds the keys, data sought by the government through legal process can be provided. If the customer holds the keys and the government wants access to the customer's data, it would need to go to the customer directly. The cloud provider can only be compelled to provide what it has, encrypted data. And similarly, the device manufacturer cannot provide access to the data on the device or provide decrypted data. This is a key issue, pun intended. The third-party doctrine has a profound and fundamental effect on cloud-based services and our own personal and business dealings, both in the cloud and in our everyday lives. In Smith versus Maryland and United States versus Miller back in the 1970s, the U.S. Supreme Court held there is no reasonable expectation of privacy in information a person voluntarily provides to a third party as a matter of United States constitutional law. Now, while the third party doctrine is a U.S. legal concept, because most of the major cloud and service providers are either U.S. companies or have a significant enough U.S. presence, the third-party doctrine has a profound effect on all of these providers' business models and on users' privacy expectations, no matter where in the world they are. The most important case currently pending affecting cloud-based services in the industry today is the United States versus Microsoft case. Microsoft is challenging a U.S. government search warrant seeking access to customer emails stored in Dublin, Ireland. The U.S. District Court issued a search warrant and ruled in favor of the United States. Microsoft has appealed to the Second Circuit Court of Appeals, but no decision has yet been made. An important point here is, as of the date of this quick look, the U.S. Second Circuit Court of Appeals has not ruled on the appeal of Microsoft. The U.S. government's objective is to establish that any cloud service provider within the jurisdiction of the U.S. must comply with a U.S.-issued search warrant, regardless of where the data is stored and notwithstanding local country law of where the data is stored. As such, a U.S. search warrant would effectively have worldwide application. In furtherance of this objective, the FBI has successfully lobbied to amend Rule 41 of the U.S. Federal Rules of Criminal Procedure. The proposed amendment to Rule 41, if not blocked by Congress, would allow the FBI under a single U.S. search warrant to remotely access a computer anywhere in the world. one warrant may cover many computers, many thousands of computers, and allow the U.S. government to utilize network investigative techniques, which means basically hacking, the use of deception, setting up a man-in-the-middle attack to obtain data provided for in the warrant. This is essentially targeted at Tor to assist in Tor investigations and or where anonymizers are used to conceal or mask a true IP address. Well, by now, everyone viewing this quick look will have had some at least passing familiarity with the infamous FBI versus Apple case arising from the 2015 San Bernardino terror attacks in California. In 2014, Apple made a conscious choice to encrypt data on its iPhones such that not even Apple can decrypt the data. The issue is, to what extent can a U.S. court compel a manufacturer to assist the government in unlocking one of its products in response to a search warrant, where the data is strongly encrypted by design of the product itself? In the absence of specific U.S. legislation, and there is none today, the U.S. government hung its hat on the All Writs Act dating back to 1789. The All Writs Act allows a court to issue all necessary writs in order to effect legal process, in this case, the search warrant. We don't have time to go over the details of the FBI versus Apple case in this quick look, but suffice it to say that by the time the FBI, through the U.S. Department of Justice, went to court to compel Apple to effectively hack its own product, the FBI had already obtained from Apple the data that was previously backed up to the iCloud from that phone and all application data from downloads from the Apple Store. Now, Apple encrypts its data in the iCloud, but Apple holds the keys, so it can decrypt and comply with government demands. In addition, the telecom provider had provided the FBI with call records, the SMS information from that phone, tower location data, and other metadata. The only data sought by the FBI in that case was what was on the iPhone and not backed up to the iCloud or otherwise transmitted from the device and recorded on another system. So the key question in that case is, in the absence of specific legislation, can a court conscript a company to develop code to effectively hack or compromise its own product to comply with a search warrant? Well, the global implications of the Microsoft and the Apple cases are, well, quite serious. A decision in favor of the U.S. in the Microsoft case would change the risk profile for companies and individuals when deciding to put data in the cloud. For example, a Thai company using a cloud service provider based in Singapore for its corporate email might find that its emails are divulged to the U.S. government without going through any legal process in Singapore at all, and perhaps even in violation of Singapore law if the cloud provider has sufficient presence in the U.S. In addition, if the U.S. government is successful in compelling through court-ordered legal process a device manufacturer like Apple to provide a backdoor or other access to encrypted data on its products, other governments will follow suit. This would likely provide incentives for third parties to develop applications to enhance security, effectively resulting in an arms race to keep control of users' data. So at this point, the only certainty is that we have uncertainty. And as such, the recommended strategy for a company in this space would be to make the government have to go to the customer for the customer data. Build in strong encryption in the cloud and devices and put the encryption keys only in the hands of customers or trusted third parties. What happens in the United States will continue to drive global markets and business models. And this is really not just about law enforcement lawful access. Courts in civil cases can also order a provider to divulge customer data stored in clouds and in devices. Thank you very much.